In the initial level, you will not be able to do many things because your whole consciousness, your whole attention is necessary. Your whole awareness is demanded. You need to be completely aware. Your whole consciousness is necessary. But by and by, if you train yourself, you can push all the decision making, all the plans, all the actions, all the commands in the unconscious zone. Then now, you can do the driving and speak in the cell phone, listen to the music, or sometimes even eat in Western countries, that's a restaurant also. Car is a restaurant, a street food, and music bar, everything. They do everything inside the car while driving. Be very clear, when things become unconscious, your consciousness is available to you to do something else. But the problem is, if you put a lot of things in unconscious, if you don't do anything in conscious, you are just sitting, they all will come up and disturb you. That is not going to be a permanent solution. Whatever engrams which has entered into your unconscious, they will come up. They will not let you sit quietly. They will not allow you to relax. They will not allow you to sit silently. That is why we can sit with anybody. We can't sit with ourselves. I have seen in the old people, practically don't have any responsibility. Who are retired, just enjoying their pension and living the life. They have nothing to do, even at that age, they will not be able to sit with themselves. See, when you ask young people to meditate, they say, oh, it's all, we can do it when you are old. Not necessarily now. All old people, they say, we should have done all these things in the young age. How can we do now, Swamiji? It's too late. Even in the old age, they can't sit quietly. They can't sit with themselves. I've seen, they would have been married, their kids would have been married, their sons would have been married, their daughters would have been married, even their grandkids would have been married. But they will be sitting and reading that matrimonial vow line by line. Because they can't sit with themselves, they have to do something. They are sitting and reading the matrimonial column in the newspapers. Because they have to do something, they can't sit with themselves. You can't sit with yourself if you push all the decision making into unconscious. That is very dangerous. That is why the Western society, society based on training and standardizing, created more depression, restlessness, violence, and aggressive natured beings. Society is based on training and standardization, created so many problems, so many psychological disorders, so many psychiatric problems. So many psychosomatic disorders, so much of mental diseases are created just because this training and standardization. The more you train and standardize, more you become unconscious. The depth of unconsciousness increases with more training and standardization. You think, how to live our life? Because in our life practically everything is standardized and everything is in for everything we are trained. The more you are trained for more things, the more society respects you. The more you are respected, more you are paid. What I am saying is completely opposite. Now how to handle it? Here, Shiva comes to our help. He says, do not push your decision making, plans, actions into unconscious. What do you want? After all, you want your consciousness should be peaceful. It should not be disturbed. It should be relaxed. Then try the other way. Try to elevate yourself to super conscious so that you will not be disturbed. Instead of pushing your actions, instead of pushing your decision makings into unconscious, raise yourself to super consciousness. Let me be very clear. The more things you push into unconsciousness, you will start taking decisions in a very illogical way. You will start doing things without thinking about the consequences, because you are trained to take decision from unconsciousness. You are trained to do things without much conscious analysis. If you can drive for 1 hour without even remembering you are driving, means more than 1 hour you can just stay in your unconscious and do your activities. Same way, even in the major things of your life, you will just make decision and execute in unconscious way without becoming even conscious of your decision. Because now you are habituated to take unconscious decisions and execute it without conscious awareness. If you can try 1 hour without even becoming aware that you are driving, you can do something else also without even becoming aware of the consequences, or that you are doing that. You are doing that action. You are doing that thing. That is why so much of addiction happens in the societies which are based on training and standardization. Addictions, all addictions are directly connected to this problem. If you are addicted, you will forget many times the things which you are doing. Please understand, if you can drive half an hour without even being aware that you are driving, naturally you can decide to smoke or drink without even becoming aware that you are deciding to do something wrong. Because you are now habituated to decide without consciousness interfering. Just unconscious decisions come up, express themselves and execute. Use your body to realize those decisions and drop. Suddenly you realize your body has been used by somebody else to do something which you never wanted. If you think at some point of your life, I never want to do this, but I have done this, means the decisions have come to your consciousness without even you being conscious about it, and your body is used to execute that, the whole thing is over. Crime rate will be high. The societies which are based on training and standardization, because human beings are trained to act without becoming aware. Understand the danger of this training and standardization. Here, Shiva is giving you the antidote. He is trying to elevate you to a different level. He is saying completely the other way. Do not push your plans, decision making, thoughts, whatever disturbs your consciousness to unconscious, but elevate yourself, your conscious to super conscious. Means he is giving you permanent solution. Pushing into this zone is not going to help you. Training is not going to help you.
elevating yourself to that zone is only your parenting. This technique is all about elevating yourself to that zone. Let's enter into the technique again. Shiva is saying, look upon a product, look upon an object without seeing the size or the material in which it is made. Usually, when you look at some object, first thing you judge the size and shape. Next thing you judge the utility value for you in your day-to-day life. First thing you make an idea about that object. Second thing, what is there for me? What is there for me? Either attachment, if it is going to be useful, or the hatred, if it is not going to be useful. If it has got some utility value, attachment. If it has no utility value, some hatred. Either greed or fear. Either you have the glimpse of greed or you have the glimpse of fear. If it is something useful, you have the glimpse of greed. One thing, after that you may suppress it. Small example, you are standing in a signal, your car is standing in a signal. If a bigger car comes and stands next to you, naturally there is one thought, oh, the next car. There is one thought, you may suppress it, bringing so many other thoughts, no, I can't have all those things now, don't think about all those things now, we should not have greed. You can bring many more thoughts, that is different. But the first thought is there, the utility value. You see what way it can be useful for me. What way it can be useful for me. Whenever you see an object, whenever you see a person, you reduce that person into a matter. You reduce that thing into an object so that you can use it. Either you want to enjoy it or you want to possess it. Sometimes, even if you look, if you know that you are not going to enjoy, you just want to keep it in your bureau. Maybe at some point I want it. Maybe at some time I may need it. Either you want to enjoy or you want to possess. Now, Shiva is saying, look upon something without creating this kind of thoughts. You will suddenly experience a new consciousness, new inner space. Let's understand how this can happen. Whenever you look at a rose flower, the moment you see, your mind first creates the word rose. Then it starts analyzing, bringing the thoughts of all the roses which you receive, and all the roses which you presented. Then the thought moves, what was the mood which you experienced when you presented the rose or when you received the rose. And now next, the thoughts related to the person who presented or received the roses. Within few seconds, you travel far away from the rose which is in front of you. The moment you create a word, you decided to travel away from the object. You decided to travel away from the reality which is in front of you. The words which is created inside your head moves you away from the reality. That is very clear. The moment you create the word rose, you think you understood rose. You understood the word rose. Shiva says, do not create any word. Do not create any word. Before creating any word, just be aware, be present.
the more you create words, more you will be trained. You will be trained to create words without becoming aware. You see, understand? It's a very subtle truth, very deep level truth. Half an hour you grow without even becoming aware that you are driving. Means all those commands which is necessary for driving is created in your being, but you are not conscious about it. It is created in a very low frequency. Naturally, you would have had word, let me press the clutch, let me press the brake, let me turn right. Unless those words are created, your body wouldn't have done that. Those words are created and delivered to your body. Body executed those commands without even you being aware. The whole thing is happening inside your system. Inside your system, such a big department is functioning, but you are not aware. Something like that. Inside your own house, somebody else has started living. You are not even aware. You are not even aware. In your own backyard, somebody is living. He is living with his own family. You are not even aware. That's the same thing is happening in you. When you are driving for half an hour and you are not even aware, you drove for half an hour. Whenever you are doing something for hours and you are not even aware that you are doing that for hours. Ladies, can understand this example? You will be standing and cooking for 3-4 hours. You only decide how much of salt has to be added, how much of sugar has to be added, how much of spices has to be added. But at the end of the cooking, suddenly you will realize you are deeply engrossed in some thoughts, something else. Suddenly you become aware you are cooking for last 1 hour. How risky to eat that food? So many things are happening in your life in this way. Means the decision making is happening in unconscious zone. Command is given to your body and it is executed without even you being aware in the conscious zone. It's very dangerous. If you are habituated to live like this, you will have the problem of addiction. Again and again you will repent for your actions. You will do something which you never want to do without even thinking the consequences, because your system is trained to receive the command from unconscious zone. It's like that. You tell your workers, hey, from tomorrow onwards, you can listen to the manager, execute whatever commands he gives, and you go away. Now the manager can easily play his game and exploit all your workers. Same thing is happening in you. You say your senses, execute the command which comes from unconscious. Let me just rest. You are deciding. Naturally, now unconscious can play its own game and exploit your body, exploit your senses to do whatever it wants to do. The so-called training and standardization pushes your words and decision making into unconscious. Here Shiva says, pull yourself towards superconscious. Raise yourself to superconscious. It means not only you should not push your words and thoughts into unconscious, you should be aware of the words and thoughts which are coming from unconscious. Not only you should not create that push inside, you should be constantly aware what is coming from inside.